Choose life, choose a career, choose never too old to game. Welcome back, guys. We've had some more weapon tuning. Thank you very much, Raven Software. We didn't think we're going to have any more weapon tuning until Season 6 drops, so this must be the last weapon tuning we're going to get before Season 6. So that's changed up things once again, so without further ado, let's check out what my top five are for Verdansk. So, okay, you can pretty much see what I've got here. My fifth place, I have the AK-47 and the Swiss. Fourth place, the OTS and the EM2, the OTS-9 and the C-58 in third place. In second, the PPSH and the MG-82. You could switch out the MG-82 with the Stoner. And in first place, the MAC-10 with the XM4. So let's rock and have a look through fifth place. So fifth place, we have the AK-47 and the Swiss. For the Swiss, we are rocking the GRU Suppressor, the 24.9-inch combat recon barrel. For the laser, we are running the SWAT 5mm laser sight, the Bruiser grip for underbarrel, and the airborne elastic wrap for rear grip. This is a fantastic setup. This gun is the beast. In my opinion, much better than the KR-98K. Pair this with the AK-47, which it was built originally as a close-range assault rifle. This gun shreds opponents. The mobility is slightly slower, so you could rock it out instead with the PPSH. But for this, I run the GRU Suppressor, the 20-inch Spetsnaz RPK barrel, the axial 3x, the 45 rounds, and the Spetsnaz grip. However, guys, if you want, you can run it slightly different. You can run it as this setup. So the suppressor, the Spetsnaz 20-inch barrel, the Spetsnaz grip, the 45 rounds, and the Microflex LED. This helps out in terms of sprint to fire speed, as well as slightly better mobility, and you have the Microflex for that quicker ADS in. So it's your personal preference which one you want to go to, but it's up to you guys. You choose it, you use it. In fourth place, so as you can see now, I put skill level, skill plus, plus, plus. You have to be a high skill player to be using this loadout, but if you are, the EM2 is a powerhouse, the powerfulest assault rifle that you can use in Warzone currently. That's why it's high skill level, recoil is very hard to control, high bullet velocity rate, and a slow rate of fire. So this gun is a good, you have to make sure you hit those shots, or otherwise you're going to be being down by the by a worse player with an easier to use gun. So this, we run the agency suppressor. For the barrel, the 25.8-inch task force. Under barrel, the field agent grip to help us out the vertical recoil control. Magazine size, 40-round mag, and the actual 3x scope. Pair this with the OTS-9. This gun is still a powerhouse, beast up close and personal, and the best SMG for those close range engagements. For this, we run the GRU Suppressor, the Task Force Barrel, the Tiger Team Spotlight, the KGB Scheduled Stock, and the 40-round mag. Pair these two together, they are a beast. I tend to run Throw Knife so I can conserve that ammo, EOD, Overkill, and Amped. Next up in third place, the OTS-9 and the C-58. C-58 is skill level plus 2, so it's slightly easier to use, pretty much like the AMAX from Modern Warfare, but a version 2 of it. So I run this with the OTS, same setup as I do with the EM2. And for the C-58, we run the Agency Suppressor, the Task Force Barrel, the actual 3x scope, the 45-round drum, and the Field Agent Grip. This is another great gun to be using. The same thing, run this with throwing knives because I'm using the OTS-9 to conserve that ammo, EOD, Overkill, and Amped. And then in second place, we have the PPSH and the MG-82. The PPSH is a fantastic gun, pretty much jack of all trades. I like to pair it with the sound suppressor on this, instead of using that GRU suppressor, for that faster sprint to fire speed. Tiger Team Spotlight, the Spetsnaz PKM stock, 71-round mag, so I have enough ammo in my bullet case to down duos, trios, and quads, and the Bruiser grip for that aim assist in terms of hip fire accuracy and that movement speed. Pair this with the MG-82, which is an absolute powerhouse. Harder to control the recoil on those longer range engagements, but anything close, medium, and medium slightly up to long range, it is a destroyer. Pair it with a 125-round mag, and this gun is seriously packs a punch. Field agent grip to help with that vertical and horizontal read control, the task force barrel, agency suppressor, and the actual free time scope. This is pretty much a damn good gun. However, you might, if you're struggling with this, you might want to go with the Stoner instead. And for the Stoner, it's pretty much exactly the same. Running with the agency suppressor, the task force barrel, the field agent grip, the 120 round, in either the roll and cross 4x scope or the actual 3x scope. All personal preferences, I tend to use a reticle on this, which is this lovely one called Green Dot, which makes things super clear. So either of those for your choice range. And then in first place, we have the MAC-10 and the XM4. Skill level pretty much on par, not much skill required for both of these guns. MAC-10, super mobile, very easy to use. Doesn't have the damage profile for the other SMGs, like the PPSH as well as the OTS-9, but a fantastic gun to use and has a fantastic bullet velocity, which basically means that if you do miss the target and get back on, you're going to be hitting those shots. Pair this with agency suppressor, the task force barrel, the targeting spotlight, the 53 round drum mag, and the raid stock, and you are good to go. For the XM4, this is the agency suppressor, task force barrel, actual 3x, 45 round mag, and the field agent grip. And this is what I'll be using all the time in Warzone. Super easy to use. This, the XM4, is now the creep replacement in my mind in terms of damage profile, ease of use, and high bullet velocity. Pairs the EOD, overkill, and amped, and the throwing knife, also because of the fact that I don't want to be wasting my ammo with the MAC-10, so I use my throwing knife instead. And that pretty much sums it all up, guys. I hope you enjoy yourselves. This was a very short one because we've gone through lots of changes, and hopefully this is it. Oh, one other thing before you guys dump out. For my Ghost class, I rock it with the QBZ. This gun has no recoil and decent damage profiles. So if you want to rock the same, the agency suppressor, the task force barrel, the field agent grip, 60 round mag, and the actual 3x. So if I find I'm not enjoying my games and get my ass whooped, and then I'll jump in and I'll get my second loadout class, which is my Ghost class, and I'm feeling like I'm playing really pretty poor, I jump with the QBZ because I know this is pretty much the replacement, direct replacement for the Krig in terms of ease of use, no recoil, decent damage profile, very easy to use, entry level gun. So if you're feeling you want to need to be stepping back from having those better high skill guns, go with the QBZ. So guys, that's it. Thank you very much for listening. It's been a pleasure always. Make sure you like and subscribe. Laters, over and out. Have a lovely weekend.